In this video, we will discuss one concept of fundamental of data structures which is related with the searching algorithm. There is one technique which is called as a Fibonacci search algorithm, where in this case we are using one Fibonacci series which is represented by using this series which is 0, 1, 1, 2, 3, 5, 8, 13, 21 and 34. Now here this series is written in this way: 0 and 1, these are the two numbers. Then next one is written as 1 plus 0, which is nothing but 1. Then again this 1 plus 1 is added, then it is written 2. Then 2 plus 1 is 3, 3 plus 2 is 5, 5 plus 3 is 8, 8 plus 5 is 13, and 13 plus 8 is 21. So in this way this Fibonacci series is written. Now here let us consider one example where 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70. So these are the elements, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So these are the indices of these elements which is given in array form. Now here if n is total number of elements, here total number of elements are 7, then these parameters A, B and F, they are defined in this way: F is equal to N, and here N is nothing but total number of elements which are nothing but 7. So here F is equal to 7. Now here B it is written in such a way that in Fibonacci series, 7, here total number of elements are 7, but 7 here we cannot find 7. So therefore we will compare this 7 with previous element which is nothing but 5, and we will assign B as a 5. Then previous element of B, which is nothing but the 3 which is present in Fibonacci series, and this 3 is assigned as a 8. Now here F, these are nothing but the total number of elements which are 7. Then in Fibonacci series 5 is less than 7, so we will assign B as a 7, B as a 5. And then A, which is nothing but previous element of B, so therefore we will write here A is equal to 3. Now these are the variables: A is equal to 3, B is equal to 5 and F is equal to 7. Then this is the technique which is used in Fibonacci series to find out the current location or to search the element. Now here if key element means elements to be searched, if it is less than current element means if array of F, in this case array of F is nothing, F is nothing but 7, so therefore array of F is nothing but 70. Now here if key element is less than 70, then we will find out the new parameters where F is equal to F minus A, B is equal to A and A is equal to B minus A. Then we will find out the new variable which is nothing but the A is equal to 3, B is equal to 5 and F is equal to 7. Similarly, if key element is greater than the array of F, then this new elements F is equal to F plus A, B is equal to B minus A and A is equal to A minus B. So in this way these new indices are calculated, and for every iteration these indices are calculated till we will get the key element or this process is completed. Now here let us take one example. Now in this case, if key element is 20, then here key element 20 is compared with 70. Now 20 is less than 70, so therefore F is equal to F minus A. So here F is equal to F minus A, 7 minus 3 is equal to 4. B is equal to A. Now previous value of A is 3, so therefore B is equal to 3. And A is equal to B minus A, where B is 5 and A is 3. So A is equal to 2. Now here again we will compare this element, key element, with the array of F. Now F is nothing but the new value which is equal to 4. So array of F which is equal to 40. So we will compare 40 with the key element 20. And again we will repeat the same procedure. Now here for key element is equal to 60. Now in this case key element 60 is less than again 70. So this condition is true. Again we will repeat the same procedure. So this is the Fibonacci search, and here time complexity of Fibonacci search is given by big O notation log n, where n these are the total number of elements.